Hello everybody and welcome to this video. Now before the video starts, what I'd like to do is just make you aware of something I'm doing for the channel, and it's a raffle. It's a raffle for a custom rod that I've built myself. It's an estuary rod. It's a 1 to 3 ounce casting action. It's good for float fishing, lure work and light ledgering in harbours and estuaries for bass, flounders, mullets, etc. Now the link above is a video just quickly showing you the rod and all the design aspects of it. And included in the raffle is a rod bag, a cloth rod bag, hand built, a reel and a couple of lures. And the raffle is really to help me grow this channel. I'd like to do more raffles for t-shirts when I get t-shirts designed, for beach casters that I build myself. So please support this page if you can. 15% of the raffle ticket goes to Make-A-Wish Foundation as well. So it all gives a little bit to charity and it all helps this channel out as well. So in the description of this video, the first line is the link to the raffle. Click on that link, takes you straight to the raffle. It's on the website called Raffle, which is the only trusted website by Google, Apple. So it's secure and you can go on there, enter the raffle. You're then supporting Make-A-Wish as well, and you're supporting this channel, and it gives you a really good chance to win this rod. Please purchase a ticket or two. Anyway, let's get on with the video. Good morning everyone and welcome back to the channel. Now I was heading out this morning to the area of Deal. I've currently just parked in Walmer car park. It's free. It's amazing, a free car park, wow. And I was looking out at the scene, it was looking lovely, lovely and calm. I was looking forward to it. And then I've come down onto the beach and I don't think I'm gonna fish here. Because look at all the weed, and this is fresh weed on the last tide, all the way along the beach. All this big weed. I can still see it in the water as it rolls. There's a lot of weed there, and I think this is just going to cause me a load of grief. So looks like I'm gonna have to come up with a different plan. Little crested grebe catching some dinner out at sea. Do I risk it? I just don't know. I'm thinking no. Well, now, this is a bit of a change. I have come from Walmer, near Deal, to Reculver. The tide is nearly in, so fishing it over the high and then down a little bit. And I am joined by Mark. There's Mark unloading his car. Hopefully, either me or him, or both of us, will get into some fish. It'd be nice. It's not the venue of first choice, but the water seems clear of weed. I did watch the weed at Walmer for a bit and it was just getting dragged back into the sea, and the sea was getting full of it, so it would have been unfishable. So let's give it a go here. We're going to make the walk over the hill there by the towers and get down onto the beach. So let's go.
rigs, and in front of me here, I've got two rigs out. I have got a pulley dropper rig. So I'm going to put that pulley dropper rig on with a panel set up with two big hooks. I'm going to put a squid on that and see whether there's any bass around. So on that, I'm just putting a 170. And on the other rig, I'm just going to put this 170 with a two hook. There it is, two hook clip rig. Just worms, scratching around, see if there's anything about. So let's clip these up and then we'll get them baited up. All right, so we have it in front of me. A squid, still a bit frozen, but that's fine. So what I'm gonna do is, from the top here with the squid, I'm gonna measure the length of the hook. These hooks are the same, so I'm basically measuring the length of the panel hook. There, so what I'm gonna do is put the first hook roughly where the second hook will be. I'm gonna take that back out the other side, like so. Move that hook out the way. Then I'm gonna push that head back into the body, like so, hold it in place. I'm gonna reverse that hook round on itself. I'm gonna take it through the body of the squid, out through the mouth part, which is buried in there, of the squid, and turn that around like so. And then pull the line tight, like that. Now I'm gonna bait elastic that up now. Get that tight on this first hook. Then as I'm getting to where the line passes through the squid, I'm gonna bring this hook down and go through the squid the opposite way till it comes out the other side, like so, and then carry on elasticing that onto the hook shank all the way up. There we go, nice and neat. There we go, nice and neat on there, straight squid, good presentation. It's just another thing that keeps your mind at rest, not sitting there worrying about the presentation of your bait. There we go, looking lovely. Let's get this clipped up, get this out first.
London to Barcelona.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I didn't have a look at it.
Right, let's thread a worm per hook on a needle. These are the worms that I got probably 5 days ago from Ron Edwards. Basically, what I've done is I put them in a very shallow baking tray in the fridge with a little bit of seawater. And I've changed that water every day and kept them alive. All I'm going to do is an overhead thump. I'm not too worried about getting as far as I can with this. That'll do nicely. Right, let's get this in the rest. Let's have a look what Mark's doing.
Hello, Mark.
All right,
mate, so what are you up to? What are you going to fish for? What are you hoping?
Anything I possibly can. We'd like a bass, but obviously I think this time of year what we're all waiting for is a nice cod.
yeah, chance will be a fine thing, I think. That's a good bait, though. I mean, if there's rays about, they'll take that, won't they? So what you got on there?
So I've got a bit of bluey, a bit of squid on a
nice
panel.
Yeah.
And I've just obviously hooked through, a bit frozen at the moment as well. But
yeah.
There's something out here with a half decent sized mouth.
It will swallow that.
Well, hopefully.
Hopefully, yeah, let's hope.
That's what she said.
And then what have you got on your other one, mate?
Well, I've got.
Oh, you got one up,
one down.
One up, one down.
And I've got a couple of, obviously, worms on that. and then just chuck that over slightly, probably a little bit, not too far, Matt.
Yeah, and to see if...
So
we'll
get anything on it.
Right, well, I'll let you get baited up, get your stuff out, mate, and let's see if we can get some fish. Is happening, so it's well worth a try. Well, Mark's struggling with a big lump of weed. So not only have we got an enormous load of crab activity, got a lot of weed coming in now. And have you got any bait, Mark? It's the million-dollar question. No. Cleaned. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Two hooks completely cleaned.
There's a little bit of elastic there.
Yeah. Well, Mark's still got two rods. One's in now that he's got in his hands, but his other one's still out. My tripod is empty. And that is because I've given up. It's one of them days. Hasn't even been a day. It's been 4 hours. Drove all the way to Deal, and it was weed everywhere. So ended up coming here because it was sort of between where me and Mark were. And there's crabs, weed, no fish. So I am not wasting my time or my bait. I've got better things to do. So I don't know what Mark's gonna be doing. What are you doing, Mark? Are you going to be carrying on fishing? He's going home as well. So we are a right couple of blankers, exactly that. Yeah, we're going to call it a day. What a disaster. This happens in fishing. So until next time, when hopefully there will be some tight lines.